How's it going, everyone? Skipper VR here. Hope we're having an amazing day, and I am back to talk about a game that I know we're all very excited for, and that's the new game from Stress Level Zero, Bone Lab. Now, we knew this game was in development for quite a while, but we didn't get much news besides a few tweets and some concept art. But then last Wednesday, during the gaming showcase, we got some actual news and a trailer for this game, which I was pretty hyped to see. Roll the clip.
I feel like whoever chooses the songs for Beat Saber
doesn't have a
very
good taste in music. Last year, there was one game that a lot of you
Waterworks!
And good things come to those who wait.
Today,
I'm excited to introduce you to Stress Level Zero's fourth project, Bone Lab.
Now, Boneworks is one of my favorite games of all time, and as many of you may know, it's definitely my favorite VR game. So the idea for a sequel is super exciting, because I've already finished Boneworks 100% and played all the sandbox and arena modes to my heart's content. But this game looks different. It looks like the main draw of this game is the replayability and the creative aspect of it, which is what I want to break down. So strap in as we go over everything you need to know about Bone Lab. Before we get into it, you know the drill. If you like what you see, be sure to hit that subscribe button for more awesome VR content. It doesn't hurt. And if you like the video, you should make a 5-page essay going over the pros and cons of this video before deciding if you want to hit that like button. Or don't. I'm not your professor. I make VR YouTube videos in my spare time. Alright, so first things first, I think it's valid to read the description on the Oculus store page, so let's do that together. Sentenced to death, you embody an outcast escaping fate, discovering a pathway to a hidden underground research facility. A series of challenging experiments and discoveries awaits. A road to the truth calls from the void. Layered narrative. After discovering an underground lab in MythOS City, you will have access to a variety of game locations including arenas, obstacle course, tactical trials, sandbox, and experimental modes, and user-generated levels. Collecting items and avatars and clues from these locations enable you to progress through the mysterious story. Physics to the core. Boneworks' realistic physics systems fully improved and polished. Interact with the game world with consistent confidence. Oof, that was a mouthful. Visceral VR combat. Using a variety of ranged, melee, and exotic physics weapons, engage enemy encounters with an entire armory at your disposal. Be anyone you want. Custom avatar importing enables you to play through the game looking however you want, with the physical stats to match. So the first thing I want to break down is, of course, the story. Now, we don't know much about this because the synopsis is very vague, but here's what I think. Now, I have a couple theories if this is a direct sequel to Boneworks, but I don't think it totally is, but these theories would make perfect sense if it is. I'm gonna say there are three possible ways the story can start, but take them with a grain of salt, please. The first one is that the ending of Boneworks is retconned, and it takes place after the first ending cutscene where you're in that kind of jail, if you remember, and it goes from there. Secondly, as many of you guys may know, the character you play as, his real body is shot and killed by some guy in a suit, which made me think that you're definitely not playing as Arthur. But then I remembered, at the end of the game, the screen doesn't cut to black as soon as he is shot, and you actually see these like void spirits surrounding you, so this means Arthur's consciousness still exists in the virtual world, and those spirits are damning him to death in the virtual world, and that's where Bone Labs picks up. And lastly, I could be reading into this way too much, and it's just a separate story set in the same universe, but I do think the second theory holds up pretty well. If I'm missing something, please let me know down in the comments below. I think we need to go over the weapons in the combat next. In the trailer, we only see one new weapon, which is this shotgun, which is going to be sick, I just know it. But I'm sure we can expect more than that, and secondly, it mentions an armory, so it's a possibility that we will see some wearable items, such as like a bulletproof vest or knight's armor, which is a neat idea, and I can't wait to see if it actually plays out like that. Next thing I need to mention is customizable avatars. Now, this game is going to have good mod support, but I'll touch more on that in a bit. So they stated that you're able to import any avatar you want into the game, which is really cool. So I can play as Batman if I wanted to. One of y'all need to import a Batman skin. But I think you can also customize your avatar without importing anything, because in the trailer you can see cutscenes where the avatar is a different race, and in the first scene you can see the avatar changing weight, so I don't think it's unreasonable to assume that we can customize our own avatars. I'm honestly really excited to see how this mechanic plays out. One new addition that is super neat is the new menu room slash hub area. Instead of this flat selection screen we see in the first game, we see a new one with a lot more depth. It's a large room without a ceiling floating through space, but the really neat part is the way to access the different game modes is through different doors. And the ones that we see in the trailer are Arena, Tactical Trials, and my personal favorite, Mods. Now, the Arena one has the same kind of vibe as the Arena game mode in the first game, with the fake medieval feel. We can see this by the wooded gate and the massive yellow pipe going through it. I don't know, I'm a huge fan of the aesthetic of this one. And Attack Charles is pretty basic, it's just a blank room with a target and a door, but Mods is really visually pleasing. I mean, it's legit shaped like an arcade cabinet, and even has that like neon arcade rug that we all know and love. The industrial feel is also present with this one with the door and the pipe along the back. On the top we can see a somewhat unintelligible picture, the background is a neon sunset vaporwave-esque picture, and on the right we see a man with a hazard suit on surrounded by some void stuff, I guess, and on the left we can see a fantasy-like character sporting a sword and a shield. I like this one because we can tell there is going to be a wide range of things and vibes present in this mod section, but I'm still a little confused on why mods have their own section and just aren't present in the sandbox area, but that's not big of a deal. It's probably going to be like user-generated levels in that section, so I think that makes sense. Now, one pretty vague thing we know about this game is its release date. Now, it says 2022, but I honestly wouldn't be surprised if this gets delayed, but I think a plausible time frame would be sometime late July through mid-September of 2022, of course, but that's just me speculating. Anything that was present in the first game, such as physics and such, will also be in this game. I feel like I need to at least briefly mention it, but I don't think it's important to talk about. I just hope it's slightly improved because it could always use some polish. One last thing that I totally forgot to mention is the enemies in this game. Now all of them look the exact same except for the Nullmen, who have a different kind of pattern. And one new enemy we see in this game, and it's very prevalent in the trailer, is the skeletons. Now I feel like the skeletons are going to be super fun to fight and will probably be a big part of the game because they were in the trailer so much. So yeah, I just wanted to mention that really quickly. Alright, so that's going to be it for me today. I can't wait to play this game for myself and see all the great things the community does for it and to see how much heart and effort the people at Stress Level Zero have put into this thing. I'm really anticipating it. I think I want to stream this game when it comes out because I really enjoyed streaming last week and I only really do it during big events and giveaways and announcements. So yeah, if you want to see that, let me know if you guys are interested. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't already and go write your essay on my video. Have an absolutely amazing day. Have fun exploring that virtual world. And as always, take care, guys.